The heart of your teams. The heart of Michigan. That was Sports Detroit. The heart of the fan.
Breaking news from the NHL. Patrick Kane is a Detroit Red Wing. Patrick Kane, a new home. Third original 16. He's going to Motown, the Mortar City, Hockey Town, USA, the Detroit Red Wings.
First off, Patrick Kane chose the Detroit Red Wings, which means he thinks there's something here to be competitive and certainly helps in that department.
It's showtime in Detroit. Patty Kane making his Red Wings debut. What can we expect? I'll
stand up. Scores!
Bingo!
Patrick Kane! Bingo!
His first as a Red Wing!
Point shot in off the break. It goes down. Scores! Kane gets another one! Moves in for Kane.
Patrick, thanks for taking time to do this with us. It's been a pleasure to watch you work with this team over the last couple of months, and I'm wondering, from your standpoint, has your experience so far in Detroit been everything you expected it to be?
Yeah, it's been great. Really happy with everything from, the guys on the team, to coaches, to training staff, to just being in the city of Detroit and playing for the Red Wings and being a Red Wing. It's been everything I expected and more.
When you were going through the selection process of the team you wanted to play with next, you said it was important to play in a place where hockey mattered to the fans. Why was that?
Well, I mean, I think just growing up, when I really enjoyed hockey, obviously the Red Wings were winning Stanley Cups, and you could see videos of fans outside the building and just, the whole hockey town vibe. Playing in the Joe when I was younger, I thought it was always a special place to play. It was my favorite place to play in the world, just the rink and the old school atmosphere and, how good the ice was and the fans just, seemed to be, unbelievable, especially when we played them in playoffs. But, nowadays I think they're really building something here, and the crowd's been amazing every night, and it's, I think, a big reason why we do have some success here at home, but it's been awesome to play in front of the crowd here at LCA.
He's an original 16 for him, and hopefully he can get the chemistry back with the Brinket tonight.
I hope he means a lot to them, because I think he's a great playmaker, and I think as long as they mesh real well and see how far they can go.
You know? Just buy that right now, or did everybody?
I literally just bought it, yeah.
True story. After the Oilers game, I went into the team store. I was going to buy a red 88 Kane jersey. It sold out. Sold out of the red ones, sold out of the white ones. How have you felt the fans have welcomed you and accepted you as a Red Wing into the Motor City? They've got love for you here.
Yeah, I guess that's cool to know. I didn't know that. But, I think it's been great. I mean, the reception's been great. I guess you never really know what to expect, especially coming from, a big rival in Chicago for so many years. But they've been unbelievable. I really believe they've welcomed me with open arms, and the signs and warm-ups, or the ovations during games or after games going out for one of the three stars, things like that. Your name getting announced in the starting lineup, you can feel that that love from the fans, so it's been greatly appreciated.
You just mentioned when you were young growing up, the Wings were winning Stanley Cups. When you were young, what made you fall in love with the game of hockey? Do you remember what it was, when it was?
Yeah, I mean, I think, the funny thing is a lot of people ask me, how much I skated as a kid, or, how many teams I played for, things like that. But for me, it was always, it wasn't really like I was working at my game, It was just something I loved to do. I loved to go to skate and shoot after school. I loved to do, three-on-three on a small hockey rink at Monday nights back in Buffalo when I was a young kid. Things like that just really made me fall in love with the game. But I would say it'd probably be maybe around 8, 9, 10 years old when I started, you know, I'd go to a lot of Sabres games and probably like 25 a year and just watch them, watch the other team, watch the best players on the other teams and just try to learn as much as I could.
Yeah, and your dad had Buffalo Sabres season tickets would take you to games. How much did that time mean to you, that time spent with your dad, that time taking in the game, learning about the game? When you look back, what does that mean to Patrick Kane today?
Yeah, it was special nights for sure. We actually had seats behind the visitors' bench, so I was able to like lean over and look at all the sticks lined up on the rack and just, you know, enjoy things like that. Kind of put my ear up to the glass and see what the coaches were saying to the players. Just kind of learn that way. But it was also fun too. I mean, I love going to the games and cheering on the Sabres, and that was kind of like in Hasek's heyday. I know he had some success here as well, but. He was unbelievable there in Buffalo, so it was fun to watch him on a nightly basis. And just little things like me and my buddies would meet up in the intermission, and we'd play mini sticks in the hallway. And my dad always had a rule that I had to be back on time for the start of the period. So, you know, if there was, you know, games that he didn't come with me and I just went with my buddies, and sometimes we'd skip a little bit of the period, he'd know just from the watching on TV. So we always had to make sure we were down at the start of the period to watch the game. But yeah, it was fun.
Playing mini sticks, flipping hockey cards, that kind of thing.
Playing mini sticks, I mean, just getting in line for ice cream. It was a big night.
Wingspan is brought to you by Coors Light, made to chill.
For the first time since 1961, the Chicago Blackhawks have won the Stanley Cup.
Yeah, this is my sister Erica, my oldest sister. She's 21? 20. I'm 21. This is Jacqueline. She's the athlete in the family. And then Jessica, my mom, and my dad.
Your dad had season tickets to the Sabres, but then to come and watch you play at the NHL level every night. What did that mean to him and your relationship as the years went by?
Well, I think he's just a fan of the game. I mean, he grew up a fan of the game. I think he actually proposed to my mom at a Sabres game. Okay. So just loved hockey. So I think it was special for him to have a son that, you know, played in the NHL and was able to play at the highest level. So he came to a lot of games in Chicago. He would drive 8 hours. You know, he doesn't like to fly, so he would drive 8 hours there, sometimes drive 8 hours the next day back if we were going on the road or something. So a lot of sacrifice, a lot of time in the car, but he said it was all worth it just to come to like things like the morning skate and watch me skate, or you know, watch the team play that night. Just things like that he really enjoyed. So it's a little bit easier on him now that I'm in Detroit. It's about you know, maybe 4 hours from Buffalo. So I think he's a little bit, I think he was happy when I chose Detroit. That was a little bit closer to home.
Yeah, he and I have talked, too, about making that drive through Woodstock and London during the winter and the storms. Yeah. And he said there were times he didn't know how he made it through there.
Yeah,
but you know the sacrifice it is to make those kind of journeys. How much has being a father changed your approach to the game and life and just your all-around outlook?
Yeah, I think game, not so much. I mean, I think I'm still, you know, very competitive, still want to do whatever I can to feel as best as I can for the next game or that night, just prepare as much as possible. And I think Amanda understands that. She's been an unbelievable mom to Patrick so far. She sacrificed so much just to kind of take care of him and be there for him as much as possible if I'm on the road or if I'm, you know, training or whatever it is. But yeah, it's great. Like, the best thing about it is, like, even after a day like today, going home and being able to play with him for a few hours before he goes to bed and just hang out with him and, you know, kind of put all the other stuff aside, whether it's your phone or just your thoughts about hockey or just things at the rink, and you can just hang out with them and kind of leave everything to the side. It's the best part.
Yeah, and you've talked a lot about your family and your mom and your dad being there. You've got three sisters as well that are obviously big supporters of you.
Yeah.
One of my favorite memories is my parents, one of the things they always did for us is there was always a pool at the hotel.
Okay.
So my brother would take naps before his game every single time. So me and my sisters would head down to the pool, and when we would come back in, we had to be as quiet as we could. When you're trying to be quiet, we would get in a fit of laughter.
Okay.
We would drop everything.
Of course.
Yeah, so it would be horrible, but it was fun because we're always together as a family. And still to this day, he takes his nap before every single game.
They would be, you know, doing their homework in the crowd or, you know, playing with their dolls. Like, they're probably sick of coming to watch me play. But, yeah, just, you know, another example of sacrifice, like coming to, you know, Toronto or Montreal or wherever these tournaments were and just, you know, sacrificing their weekend with their friends just to come and watch me play so we could be together as a family and we'd all be together in one hotel room, have a couple cots in there and just really enjoy each other too. Like, we had a lot of fun at those tournaments. So I think they're working on planning a trip down here to Detroit. My one sister came already, but the other ones are planning on coming down too, my friends as well. So I think everyone's pretty excited.
Look up and warm up and see your dad and your mom and your son and your girlfriend there at the games. But what's that mean today?
Oh, it's the best. It's the best when all four of them are there. You know, I think it's amazing when my son comes to the game and just, you know, you see him on the glass, he's wearing your jersey, he's excited to see you. I'm probably even more excited to see him, but just kind of puts you in a different zone, gets you happy before the game. So I love when they're able to be there and come to warm ups. And my parents too. I mean, They've really sacrificed a lot for me to get to where I am professionally. Just things like, you know, I moved away from home when I was 14 years old. I actually moved to play for Honey Baked here in Detroit and lived in Birmingham. So it seemed like we made a lot of tough decisions when I was younger to help my hockey career, and it seemed like most of them are the right ones.
There's Larkin firing, save made, Kane rebound, scores! Patrick Kane!
They're bringing in Patrick Kane. It was pretty significant hip surgery, required 6 months away from the game, so you're not sure what you're going to get. But if Kane can even return to a semblance of his former self, the self that won 3 Stanley Cups with the Chicago Blackhawks, then this could be a major move.
It's great to see you back on the ice. For those who really aren't familiar with the surgery that you went through to continue playing your career, in layman's terms, explain what you went through and the process of rehabbing.
Yeah, so I mean, I think the biggest thing was just the joint over time was just kind of worn down. So it wasn't like a simple decision where I could go in and, you know, repair the you know, shave down the bone, or if I was bone on bone, or repair the labrum. So I had to go with the resurfacing. The resurfacing, you kind of put like you shave down the head of the femur, you put a cap on top, and then a ball into the cap, and it just kind of eliminates all that impingement pain or bone-on-bone pain that you know, a lot of people deal with, a lot of hockey players deal with as they go on with their careers. So, yeah, kind of a tough decision because it's not really a proven surgery. I know, right. Nick Backstrom came back from it, but you know, a couple other guys seemed to try. It's like you didn't really get an answer if it was they were, you know, stopping playing because it was the end of their career and they're a little bit older because of the hip. So the doctor was pretty confident with everything that I'd be able to play at a high level for a number of years, and that's kind of what got me, that he said, you know, I won't have to, you know, retire because of my hip. So it was a big decision, probably took me about a month to make, and I decided to go for it just because of the last couple of years, just, you know, being in pain every day and not being able to have the mobility I had when I was younger just really wears on you over time. So really happy with everything so far. I mean, I think the exciting thing for me is it's getting better and better as time goes on, even from my first game to where I'm at now. Like, the hip feels better, the confidence, and just like the injury and being able to play with it after is a lot better too. So I feel like things are heading in the right direction. Yeah, it's I guess it's a new kind of procedure, but hopefully it'll save a lot of careers in the long run.
Gonna wait, 2-on-1 for Chicago. Kane's going down the slot. He's got the puck. Score! Oh, boy! Kane, watched by Kimo Tiivanen, to the net! And he stopped it. Where's the puck? It came loose to the other side. It's over! Patrick Kane has scored the goal!
Kane is gonna get a lot of ice time tonight.
Scores!
Big goal!
Patrick Kane!
Big goal!
His first as a Red Wing!
The game's changed a lot, Patrick. It's fast as ever right now. What are some of the biggest changes you've seen in the game?
Yeah, I think you mentioned it right there. Just the speed of the game is, it's, it's even so much different from 10 years ago. I think the game 10 years ago, when our teams were winning, it was a lot more control, a lot more structure. Now it's all about speed. You know, get the puck ahead, chase it down, see if you can, you know, outrun a guy and create a chance that way. It's not as controlled anymore, but you know, I think there's a lot of skill in the game too. I mean, you don't really see those fourth liners that play, you know, 3, 4, 5 minutes anymore. Like, there's a lot of players around the league that can play and be effective, and everyone has skills, coaches now. Everyone's training in the summer as hard as possible. So the game's just trending in a great direction. It's incredible to see some of the talent these guys have now.
So what's the secret to controlling the game at your pace, even though everybody's flying around at their pace?
Yeah, I think it's change of speed, right? Like, you want to be deceptive with it, whether it's speeding up at certain points off of, you know, slower start, or maybe accelerating into, you know, like stopping and pulling up and trying to make a play that way. So I think over the course of years, that's kind of been a play for me that's been pretty effective, is coming down the right wing, create space, pull up, try and hit the late guy, cross ice plays. Feel like I can make those plays, but I think anytime you can get time and space in this league and get moving and get some momentum behind you, then, you know, you have the chance to make some plays with you know, some great players around you. So it's all about time and space.
Chance right in, scores, Kane! And a 4-game goal streak now for Showtime.
Wingspan is brought to you by Coors Light, made to chill.
I've obviously watched him his entire career. I've met him a couple of times, had a couple of brief conversations with him. But the more we, you know, you look into a person, he's like just really a, like, he's all into hockey. He knows the league. He knows every team. He knows, he's paying attention. And we were really impressed by that. And I really enjoy talking with him. And it's like, oh, it makes sense why he's been so good for so long.
I know when you came here, you talked about the admiration you had for Steve Yzerman and the admiration he has for you and the way you guys approach the game. I'm just wondering who else you see that sort of embodies what you typify as a hockey player, that has that kind of passion and drive and love for the game, and guys you follow throughout your career.
Yeah, I mean, I think just playing with the Brinkett over the years, he's definitely a hockey nerd as well, like, to the point where, you know, we could talk about plays that we've seen on a game at night and kind of text each other, you see this, you see that. Dylan Strome was like that as well when we played with him in Chicago. Talked a lot of hockey with him, but Alex is definitely a hockey nerd as well. And I think that's why he's so successful too. He wants to be the best at what he does. Like, he watches the game, he knows what he's capable of. He's obviously very competitive. I think that's one thing that's underrated about him too, is his competitiveness. But he wants to be the best every night, and that's why I love the chance to play with him.
I compare your game in a kind of a way to Pavel Datsyuk, Henrik Zetterberg, guys who control the pace of play when the puck is on their stick, regardless of the speed of the game. What were your thoughts of playing against guys like Datsyuk and Zetterberg, and how they controlled the game and how their skills match yours in that sense?
Yeah, I mean, they were incredible. I remember coming into the league as a rookie, and we would watch a lot of film on Zetterberg and Datsyuk, just things they did around the net and the way they played. And we'd go out, myself and Taser, Johnny Taze, we'd go out and practice things maybe like 15-20 minutes before practice with the assistant coaches that Zetterberg and Datsyuk were doing, just to kind of, you know, work on things that they were doing that were successful, right? But, I mean, I think you look at those two guys, like, you think of players that are scary to play against. Sometimes you think of, like, real big physical players, but those two guys were the scariest guys for me to play against, just because not only could they make you look foolish with the puck, but they were so good defensively, they could take the puck from you just in a heartbeat without you even realizing what happened. And Datsyuk did that to me a few times. I remember one time in Chicago, he got me at the blue line with, like, 10 seconds left in the period. Like, just a dumb mistake to give the puck up, and tried to make a move on him, he took it from me, went down and scored. And you're just like in awe of what he's doing, but shaking your head that he did it to you. So those two guys were definitely some of my favorite players.
But the list of your accomplishments speaks for itself as well. 3 Stanley Cups, a Conn Smythe, a Hart Trophy, the Art Ross, 2 100-point seasons, 2 40-goal seasons, a Stanley Cup game winner in OT, 4 international medals as well along the way. What are you most proud of when you look back at this stage?
Yeah, that's a good question. I think, you know, you play the game to win, right? I think, you know, being part of three Stanley Cup winning teams was just, in 6 years, was incredible. Like, you're just on top of the world for that amount of time, to the point where you expect to win every year. And then when it doesn't start going your way, you're just like, am I ever going to get back there again? So hopefully we have the chance to do that this year. It'd be fun to be back in the playoffs and competing for the Stanley Cup. That's what you want to do as a player, so really proud of that. Obviously, you know, being, I think I was the first American-born player to win the Hart Trophy. That was special, too. Austin Matthews has done it since, but that was pretty cool, too, because you grow up idolizing a lot of these guys like Chelios and Madonna and, you know, great American-born players, Jeremy Roenick, and to be the first to do that was pretty cool, too.
And here comes Larkin. Hit the goal post. Rebound. Scores.
Bingo.
Patrick Kane.
Well, Patrick, you've been to the top of the mountain. You know what it takes to get there. What do you see inside this room, and what's it going to take here in Detroit to get there again?
You know, I think the roster's built really well to make a deep run. You know, we have a lot of depth. I think you need that in playoffs. You need scoring from all four lines. So you obviously have that capability. You know, strong defense. I think the goaltending position is kind of figuring itself out with the way Alex Lyon is playing lately. I know Husso's been hurt, and he's a great goaltender as well. But I think the sky's the limit with this group. If we can kind of understand the way to play and each guy understand his role on the team, I think you know, we can definitely make a run.
Well, Patrick, it's been great to watch you work, and I speak for all the Red Wings Nation. We say we can't wait to see what's next.
Yeah, thank you. Thanks for having me.
Loose in for Kane.